for later.
So not to be too difficult, but we've been coming here for 2 days just staring at this thing. Not really sure what we're supposed to be doing.
Ludovico Buonarroti. Michelangelo's father. He was a wealthy man, had no understanding of the divinity in his son, so he beat him. No child of his was going to use his hands for a living, so Michelangelo learned not to use his hands. Years later, a visiting prince came into Michelangelo's studio and found the master staring at a single 18-foot block of marble. Then he knew the rumors were true that Michelangelo had come in every day for the past 4 months, stared at the marble, then gone home for his supper. So the prince asked the obvious, "What are you doing?" And Michelangelo turned around and looked at him and whispered, "Sto lavorando. I'm working." Three years later, that block of marble was the statue of David.
We're not going to stare at this thing for 4 months, are we? How are we going to open it?
Well, that's what we have to figure out. That's why we're sitting here. I mean, how do you open a hatch that has no handle, no latch? No discernible way of opening.
John?
Looking for salvage from the crash.
Find anything useful?
Occasional scrap of metal, a few bags of coffee. Picked up your path about a mile back. I thought I'd say howdy.
Oh, son of a... Oh! Peed on my shirt. Took my shirt out of the bag and peed on it. And you say this ain't personal.
He thinks the boar we're after has a vendetta against him.
Uh-huh.
That's three times it's attacked me.
Maybe it's got your scent. Doesn't like your cologne.
I don't wear cologne.
Yes, you do.
Yeah, well, the thing's got it in for me.
It's a boar, Sawyer.
My sister Jeannie died when I was a boy. I fell off the monkey bars and broke her neck. And my mother, well, my foster mother, she blamed herself, of course. Thought she wasn't watching close enough. So she stopped eating, stopped sleeping. The neighbor started talking. Afraid she might do something to herself, I guess. Ooh, that's good. Anyway, about 6 months after Jeannie's funeral, this golden retriever comes padding up our driveway, walks right into our house, sits down on the floor, and looks right at my mother there on the couch. And my mother looks back at the dog. After about a minute of this, them both staring at each other like that, my mother bursts into tears. Beautiful dog, no tags, no collar, healthy and sweet. Dog slept in Jeannie's old room on Jeannie's old bed and stayed with us until my mother passed 5 years later, then disappeared back to wherever it was she came from in the first place.
So, you're saying the dog was your sister?
Well, that would be silly. But my mother thought it was. Thought that Jeannie'd come back to tell her that the accident wasn't her fault. Let her off the hook.
Something wrong, Charlie?
Yeah. Jack. There's been an accident. In the caves. Jack's trapped in a cave-in.
Is anyone trying to get him out?
Yeah, there's a bunch of people there now.
Then why aren't you with them? You didn't come here to tell me about Jack, did you?
Locke. I can't stand feeling like this.
Come here. Let me show you something. What do you suppose is in that cocoon, Charlie?
I don't know. A butterfly, I guess?
No, it's much more beautiful than that. That's a moth cocoon. It's ironic. Butterflies get all the attention, but moths, they spin silk. They're stronger, they're faster.
That's wonderful, but...
You see this little hole? This moth's just about to emerge. It's in there right now, struggling. It's digging its way through the thick hide of the cocoon. Now, I could help it. Take my knife, gently widen the opening, and the moth would be free. But it would be too weak to survive. Struggle is nature's way of strengthening it. Now, this is the second time you've asked me for your drugs back. Ask me again, and it's yours.
Gentle, here's more than less the peanuts. My own stash. I found it in there.
What about the rest of the food?
There is no rest of the food, dude. We kind of ate it all.
What?
Okay, everybody, just calm down.
We can find food. There are plenty of things on this island we can use for sustenance.
And exactly how are we going to find the sustenance?
We hunt.
How'd you get that knife on the plane?
Checked it.
You either have very good aim or very bad aim, Mr. Locke.
His name is Locke.
Okay, Mr. Locke, what is it that we're hunting?
We know there are wild boar on the island. Razorbacks by the look of them. The ones that came into the camp last night were piglets. 150 pounds each. Which means that there's a mother nearby. A 250-pound rat with scimitar-like tusks and a surly disposition who'd love nothing more than to eviscerate anything comes near. Boar's usual mode of attack is to circle around, charge from behind, so I figure it'll take at least three of us to distract her long enough for me to flank one of the piglets, pin it, and slit its throat.
And you gave him his knife back? Well, if you've got a better idea.
Better than three of you wandering into the magic forest to bag a hunk of ham with nothing but a little bitty hunting knife? Hell no. It's the best idea I ever heard.
How are they? The others?
Thirsty. Hungry. Waiting to be rescued. And they need someone to tell them what to do.
Me? I can't.
Why can't you?
Because I'm not a leader.
And yet they all treat you like one.
I don't know how to help them. I'll fail. I don't have what it takes.
Why are you out here, Jack?
I think I'm going crazy.
Well, you're not going crazy.
No?
No, crazy people don't know they're going crazy. They think they're getting saner. So, why are you out here?
Chasing something. Someone.
The White Rabbit. Alice in Wonderland.
Yeah. Wonderland because who I'm chasing, he's not there.
But you see him?
Yes. But he's not there.
And if I came to you and said the same thing, then what would your explanation be as a doctor?
I'd call it an hallucination. A result of dehydration, post-traumatic stress. Not getting more than 2 hours of sleep a night for the past week, all the above.
All right, then you're hallucinating. But what if you're not?
Then we're all in a lot of trouble.
I'm an ordinary man, Jack. Meat and potatoes. I live in the real world. I'm not a big believer in magic. But this place is different. It's special. The others don't want to talk about it because it scares them. But we all know it. We all feel it. Is your white rabbit a hallucination? Probably. But what if everything that happened here happened for a reason? What if this person that you're chasing is really here?
That's impossible.
Even if it is, let's say it's not.
And what happens when I catch him?
I don't know. But I've looked into the eye of this island, and what I saw was beautiful.
Wait, where are you going?
To find some more water.
I'll come with you.
No, you need to finish what you started.
Why?
Because a leader can't lead until he knows where he's going. We shouldn't be this close to each other, Jack.
If we blow up, we blow up. What the hell was all that about back there, John?
What was what about?
You asked me to let you go.
That's right.
Now, that thing was taking you down the hole, and you asked me to let you go.
It wasn't gonna hurt me.
No, John, it was gonna kill you.
I seriously doubt that.
Look, I need for you to explain to me what the hell's going on inside your head, John. I need to know why you believe that that thing wasn't gonna...
I believe that I was being tested.
Tested?
Yeah, tested. I think that's why you and I don't see eye to eye sometimes, Jack. Because you're a man of science.
Yeah. And what does that make you?
Me? Well, I'm a man of faith. Do you really think all this is an accident? That we, a group of strangers, survived? Many of us with just superficial injuries? You think we crashed on this place by coincidence? Especially this place? We were brought here for a purpose, for a reason, all of us. Each one of us was brought here for a reason.
Brought here. And who brought us here, John?
The island. The island brought us here. This is no ordinary place. You've seen that. I know you have. The island chose you too, Jack. It's destiny.
Did you talk with Boone about destiny, John?
Boone was a sacrifice that the island demanded. What happened to him at that plane was a part of a chain of events that led us here, that led us down a path, that led you and me to this day, to right now.
And where's that path end, John?
The path ends at the hatch. The hatch, Jack. All of it happened so that we could open the hatch.
No. No, we're opening the hatch so that we can survive.
Survival is all relative, Jack.
I don't believe in destiny.
Yes, you do. You just don't know it yet.
Said, don't.
Jack.
Don't. It's not real. Look, you want to push the button, you do it yourself.
If it's not real, then what are you doing here, Jack? Why did you come back? Why do you find it so hard to believe?
Why do you find it so easy?
It's never been easy!
It was his idea.
sorry, John.
What are you doing here?
I needed some money. He's always been good that way. Your father's always been generous.
You told me I didn't have a father.
Well, he said that was the only way you would give it to him. It had to be your idea. He told me where to find you. He asked me to go see you. I wanted to see you.
This can't be happening. This is a misunderstanding. This can't happen to me. You wouldn't do this to me. He wouldn't do this to me.
Mr. Cooper's not seeing guests.
I'm not a guest.
I'm sorry, John.
Eddie, open the gate.
I'm sorry. I'm gonna need you to move your car.
John, please, move your car.
Everything you wanted me to do. So why did you do this to me?
Through the park. It's trekking across vast stretches of desert, rafting bloody treacherous waters.
Look, you've got no idea who you're talking to. I'm well aware of what's involved. Believe me, I probably know more than you on the subject.
In any case, it's a trying ordeal for someone in peak physical condition. That alone...
Look, I booked this tour a month ago. You've already got my money. Now, I demand a place on that bus.
You misrepresented yourself.
I never lied.
By omission, Mr. Locke, you neglected to tell us about your condition.
My condition is not an issue. I've lived with it for 4 years. It's never kept me from doing anything.
Well, unfortunately, it is an issue for our insurance company. I can't keep the bus waiting any longer. It isn't fair to the other people.
Don't talk to me about fair!
I'll get you on a plane back to Sydney on our dime. It's the best I can do.
No, I don't want to go back to Sydney. Look, I've been preparing for this for years. Just put me on the bus right now. I can do this.
No, you can't.
Hey, don't you walk away from me. You don't know who you're dealing with. Don't ever tell me what I can't do, ever. This is destiny. This is destiny. This is my destiny. I'm supposed to do this, damn it. Don't tell me what I can't do. Don't tell me what I can't.
Thank you. hop in the shower and see if I can catch up with David before the concert's over. So just give me a call if you need me.
Dr. Shepard? He's waking up. I watched the anesthesiologist. He got the full dosage.
Okay. I'll take it from here. Mr. Locke, can you hear me? John, are you awake? You just had major surgery, so I need you to try not to move and just relax, okay?
It worked.
Well, it went well, but we won't know how well you responded to the surgery.
No, Dr. Shepard, it worked. I can feel my legs.
John, it's highly unlikely that you would regain sensation that quickly, so let's just take it.
Did you see that?
See what?
You don't remember?
Mr. Locke, please, just relax. What we need to do...
What we need to do is go.
No. Hey, John.
No. Will you come with me?
We're not going anywhere. You just had extensive spinal surgery, and I need to go see my son.
You don't have a son.
What?
You don't have a son, Jack.
Doctor?
Jean, would you give Mr. Locke something to help him rest? I need to go.
Jack! I hope that somebody does for you what you just did for me.